campaign volunteers try to wake Egypt's sleepy electorate. They sprint to the finish as polls for parliament open Sunday. Ahmed Mansour entices voters with posters, music, handouts, and horns. But for some, it's all noise. Yes, of course I'm worried about the turnout, he says, but if we have a desire for change, we actually have to change. Mansour pledges more jobs, better health care, and education. But like the more than 5,000 candidates, he struggles to energize a fatigued nation.
Almost 5 years now after the uprising of January, the disappointment has sunk in finally. The expectations were very high, and not much came out.
This election is the final step in a roadmap after the military ousted President Mohamed Morsi in 2013. Despite many promises over the past 5 years, Egypt continues to struggle with a stalled economy, poor education, high unemployment, and poverty.
Since the 2011 revolution, Egyptians have voted for two constitutions, two presidents, and now two parliaments. But all the while, voter turnout has continued to decline.
Officials are afraid that voters are disillusioned and the trend will continue. Part of the reason may be they only gave the candidates 2 weeks to introduce themselves to the public. Honestly, I only knew there was an election a week ago, he says. I don't know the candidates. Honestly, no, I don't know any candidates, says this man. On what basis would I vote for anyone? Moki El-Sisi introduces himself by shaking every man's hand at a rally. The candidate for the ultra-conservative Noor Party hopes to rally its rural base. But even in predominantly Muslim Egypt, the party knows it's gonna be a struggle. The challenge for us, says the head of the Noor Party, is going to be convincing people to cast their ballot at the polling station for us. But the fatigue and confusion about who is running could have an unintentional benefit.
Probably the most important thing about this election is it can't be rigged. Nobody would know who to rig it in favor of if they thought of rigging, because there are no clear loyalties or coalitions.
Egypt will have a new parliament by the end of the year. The second round of voting is next month. But will anyone know their representative or care? Ian Lee, CNN, Cairo.